each and every one of you today. I thank God for my sister. There'll never be another Helen DeLores Bowden in this world. I love Helen. Hallelujah. Praise God. One thing about Helen. Helen is Helen. She's the same all of the time. And you're right, Carolyn. It's a blessing to have somebody in your corner like Helen. Because Helen will take it to the throne for you. Amen, amen, amen. I'm not a long-winded person. I do talk a lot now. And I do get excited about the will and the word of God. But I will not be long. Amen. I'm going to go to the word of God. Hallelujah. The scriptures are Matthew 28, 18 through 20. And it reads as thus. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Verse 19, it says, go ye therefore, praise God, and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Verse 20 says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen, amen. And your theme for today is God's command, God's commission, our call. So what you gonna do about it? He's made the commandment, he sent the command, he's given the commission. So what are you going to do?
All right.
The ball is in your court now.
All right.
There's no excuse. You can't say, I don't know.
All right.
Or God, I would have done if I had someone had told me. Right. It's in the book.
Yes.
It's in the word. Yes. He's made the command.
Uh-huh.
What is a command? What's a command? It's an order. Uh-huh. Order with authority.
Yes.
Not just giving order, but when he gave it, he spoke it with authority.
Yes.
So there's nothing nobody can come behind him and say, no, this is not the way it is done. This is what he said.
Yes.
He commanded. So there's no excuse now.
No excuse.
What is the commission? It's an assignment. It is a specific order from God himself.
Yes.
So now we know what he wants us to do. He's given us the assignment of what to do and how to do it. Now the question is, what are we going to do about it?
All right. All right.
Are we going to sit on it and rest? Are we going to move on it? Are we going to cause it to multiply and do as he said do? Even though in this word, Jesus was talking to the disciples. But the disciples are no longer here.
Right,
we are walking in their shoes now.
Yes.
He's given us that same commandment.
All right.
And that same commission.
Yeah.
When you think about the commission, he said to go, therefore, go.
Go.
He didn't say wait.
Right.
He didn't say stay.
Right.
He didn't say stand still. Right. But he said go.
Go.
Go. Go.
Right.
He didn't say go to East Jackson.
Uh-huh.
He didn't say go to North Jackson. He didn't say go to Westover. But he said go to all nations. Teaching them.
All right.
He's given us the authority because God has the authority. God gave Jesus the authority, the same authority that God has in heaven. That's the authority that he gave to his son Jesus.
Yes.
That's the authority that Jesus left on record for us.
Yes.
If you're sitting by your loved one's bedside and they're giving you their last wish, you're going to be very careful and very attentive to what they're saying. Because this will be the last time you're going to hear what they're saying. And you want to make your best to do the very, very best to carry that plan out just as it was given unto you.
Yes.
You know, sometimes our loved ones just slip away from us. We'll say, I wish I would have taken the time to listen.
All right.
Sometimes they send for us and want us to come, and we put it off and put it off, and then you'll be saying, I wish I would have gone.
Right.
There may have been something They wanted to tell me something they wanted me to do, but we missed out on it. But when Jesus got ready to leave this earth, he called his disciples together and gave them their commission to go. He didn't say wait until they come. And this is sometimes what we do. We'll just sit and wait. We're coming to the house and we'll wait for them to come. But if nobody has answered to the commission and have gone out to tell them what they said the Lord, we'll be sitting in the building waiting until Jesus returns without fulfilling his command. God's greatest command is that we love him with all of our bodies, our mind, our soul, our being, everything within us. We need to love God. He also commands that we love each other as we love ourselves. If you love yourself, you're not going to mistreat yourself. You're not going to be mean to yourself. Now, there are times I hear people say, I need some me time. That means this paycheck is all about me. I'm going to go shopping. I'm getting my nails done. I'm getting my hair done. I'm getting me a new outfit because I want to do something for me because I love me. That's the same commandment that God has given us today. We have to love our neighbor. We are sick in our neighborhood and see the devil come in and destroy our neighborhood. We sit there and let the devil come in and destroy our children. When God has given us a commandment, he said his word, I gave you the keys to the kingdom. Hallelujah. Whatsoever you should command, whatever you should loose on earth, I will loose it in heaven. Whatever I should bind on earth, I will bind it in heaven. So he's given us a commandment. We cannot walk in fear. We cannot be afraid to go into this neighborhood. We cannot be afraid to witness to this person. Because God said in his word in Ezekiel, you heard me tell them what I was going to do to them. And you did not remind them, so their blood is required at your hand. When I stand before God in the day of glory, I don't want nobody's blood to be required at my hand. Sometimes people tell me, you know, you just bold. I'm bold for God. When I was at West High, I was just bold. There was no shame with what I was, I wasn't out of control, but I was just bold. Why can I have that same boldness for God? Why can I then walk up to a sinner and say, you know God loves you? Now that's one of the most rewarding things. You walking down the street, you meet somebody, and they totally out of control, and you tell them, excuse me, do you know that God loves you? Their face light up like a Christmas tree. We're living in a dying world where man has become so conceited, so selfish, and this is what they say. It ain't none of my family. It ain't bothering me. But that's not what God said. He said, go.
Go.
Go tell them. Teaching them everything that I've taught you. Disciples beget disciples. If we don't ever go into that street, if we don't ever go into those prisons, if we don't ever tell a dying world what God said, we will be held accountable for that. A lot of things that happened in our neighborhood, it is because nobody was bold enough to step against Satan and say, you are lying wonderful, the piece of hell. Then I rebuke you, I burn you now. That's in the bottomless piece of hell in the name of Jesus. Whatever we say, we can seal it. We can seal it with the word. Because God's word is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Even though in the Bible days, Jesus was talking to Peter, John, Paul, Simon. He was talking to those disciples. But they're gone on now. The ball is in our court. He's giving the command. He's giving the commission. What are we going to do about it? What are we going to do about the assignment that's been assigned to our hand? Every assignment that God gives is not standing behind the podium. Every assignment that God gives is not sitting down in a beautiful sanctuary. But we are farmers for God. We are seed sowers. Seed sowers. We have to sow the seed. I cannot sit in this building and say, I need a field of corn. I need a field of greens. And just sit here and wait for them to come up. Somebody has to sow the seed. And God has commissioned us to sow those seeds everywhere we go. We don't have to have a club. throws by. We can't say, well, I don't know if they're going to receive. We don't never know.
All right.
When we throw seeds out into the field, right, we don't know if they're going to come up,
right,
if the rain's going to come and wash them.
All right.
But the commandment, the commission has been that we sow those seeds.
All right.
We can't wait and say, they're not old enough to understand that the devil is a liar.
Right.
Kids understand everything. They know.
Yeah.
And it's up to us. God hold us responsible.
Uh-huh.
So many kids have gone astray because nobody did take the time because it went in their household.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't affecting their house.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord gave me something once. He said, we are family.
Uh-huh.
When one family hurt, the whole family hurt.
Yeah.
And he wasn't just meaning the Bond family.
Uh-huh.
But he was meaning the family.
Uh-huh.
The neighborhood.
Yes.
Your city.
Yes.
You know, I think a lot of things that happen in East Jackson.
Uh-huh.
We have, sometimes I just count the churches. From East Chester to Lane Avenue,
uh-huh,
there's about 7 or 10 churches.
Uh-huh.
Why come we can't come on one accord?
Uh-huh.
And stop fighting among each other.
Uh-huh.
The enemy brings the division among the house.
Uh-huh.
A house divided cannot stand.
Uh-huh.
Why come we can't just lay down denomination and be about the business of God? And she says, the Lord put upon my heart to go into prayer every Saturday morning from 6 to 8. And he said, ask you, will you do it with me? Prayer is my thing.
Uh-huh.
And I said, yes. We did it. Laid on our face before God. We pleaded the blood for East Jackson.
Yeah.
That year, nothing happened in East Jackson. Her shift changed, and we could no longer do it on one accord together. The very first murder took place in East Jackson, right in front of her mother's house. The second murder took place in East Jackson, right beside my mama's house. She said, don't you see God letting us see that he heard our prayers?
All right.
We can come together on one accord.
Right.
First we go and we tell them.
Yes, yes, yes.
We sow that seed, we spread that word.
Yes.
And we tell them what thus said the Lord.
Right.
And then we come together.
All right.
On one accord.
Amen.
Touching and agreeing. Trusting God.
Yes.
God said in his word, John 14:14, we ask anything in his name, he will do it.
Yes.
John 16:23, he said, you ask anything in my name and I will give
it.
So he's given us the instructions what to do.
All right.
So we just can't sit down and say, well, I don't know. I haven't been called to preach. A lot of us hadn't been called to preach. I hadn't been called to preach.
All
right. But I sure been called to be an intercessor.
All right.
I sure I can go to God. I sure I can go to the throne.
All right.
I work at my church.
All right.
And a lot of days, I walk that sanctuary.
All right.
And I lick the blood.
Yes.
Over that sanctuary.
Yes.
Binding the spirits, casting out strong
tongues. Yes.
You know, we don't have to be in a certain position.
All right.
You may be in a place where you may not, cannot open your mouth.
All right.
But a praying spirit.
Yes.
A praying spirit. Lord God, the mission, I always pray in my faith.
All right.
In order to know how to take this thing to the streets and take it to the nation,
yes,
like God has said. You know, the nation just may be 2 blocks over. That
all
may
right
be your nation.
All
right. All right.
That may be your nation.
Uh-huh.
He's not necessarily mean you have to go to China.
All right.
Or go to Germany. Your nation could be 2 streets over.
Yes.
I heard the Lord say one day, 1 block at a time.
All right.
1 block at a time.
Yes.
Yes, everybody like to have that multiple thing said, I witnessed it, 600 souls got saved.
Yes.
But it might just be 6 souls.
Yes.
Can you imagine?
Hallelujah.
Can you imagine?
Hallelujah.
We don't have no excuse for the enemy to come in.
Because
he said, go and give us, teach them what I have taught you.
Yes.
The word.
The word.
You know, we don't just go to Sunday school and to Bible study just to have to say, I'm faithful.
All right.
Being faithful you be?
All right.
What will you be doing when your name is called?
All right.
What will you have to say when you stand before God?
All right.
Hallelujah.
You can't say, I didn't know.
All right.
Nobody has an excuse.
Thank you.
All right. All right.
If you're blind, you can hear the audio as well.
Yeah.
You can get that word in. If you can't read, you can read Braille.
Yeah.
However you need to get that word.
All right.
However you need to sow that seed.
All right.
We better be busy.
All right.
Take care of those things that God has commanded us.
Yes, Lord.
He didn't give us a choice.
Right.
We don't have a choice.
All right.
It's not our choosing.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's not our choosing.
All right.
Joshua said, choose you this day.
Yes.
You this person. Our minds have to be keen.
Uh-huh.
We have to be prayed up.
Yes.
Stay connected. We cannot allow the enemy to cause us to be disconnected from God and from His Word.
Yes.
We can't miss God when He's calling.
No.
We can't miss God. You know, we can't say, "Well, God, I can't do it now. I got to pray. I got to ask for forgiveness." We can't do that.
That's right.
That's why we have to keep a repentant spirit.
Yes.
A repentant heart.
Yes.
All through the day.
All right.
God, forgive me.
Yes.
Hear us, Shah. Hallelujah. God, forgive me.
All right.
If I done anything today, God, if it's something I did that wasn't pleasing you,
forgive me.
We don't know. Everybody don't have a deathbed experience.
Yes.
Some of them go in the twinkling of an eye. Twinkling of an eye.
All right.
Well, we got to heed to the command.
Uh-huh.
The command is to go.
Yeah.
The commission is to spread the word.
Yes.
Right. Yeah.
The commission is teaching them what has been taught to us.
Yes.
Right.
God didn't save us to be selfish,
uh-huh.
to save us and just to sit down. So I'm saying, I don't worry about that anymore. Yes, we do.
Right.
We are ambassadors for Christ.
Yes.
We are employees. Jesus has left the scene.
Uh-huh.
You know the thing about Elvis have left the building?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus has left the earth.
Yes.
But He left the word here.
Uh-huh.
He left the commission here.
Yes.
We have to take heed.
Uh-huh.
We have to be about our Father's business.
Yes. Amen.
Yes, our feelings will get hurt sometimes.
Yes,
sometimes you have to stand alone.
Right.
Yes, sometimes you have to be by yourself.
Yes.
You can't fit in the in crowd and do the will of God.
My God.
We can't live a two-sided life.
No.
Either be hot or cold. If lukewarm, your spirit is
dry.
You can't come in here on this Sunday morning and give God all the praise.
Yes.
Walk out this door and go run up back and do it. I want to be in the will of God.
Yes.
Whatever I do, I want to do it in the will of God.
Yes.
I want the Lord to be pleased with all that I do.
Yes.
You witness to loved ones. You witness to co-workers.
Yes.
They don't get saved right then and all the time. But you're sowing that seed.
Yes.
It's not up to us what day they're going to accept the word of God.
Right.
It's not up to us to tell them, "Oh, you better do it today."
Right.
Yes, we need to let them know the day is today.
Thank you.
Because tomorrow's not promised.
Thank you.
Right. Yesterday is gone, and tomorrow may never be back.
Right.
But the thing of it is, following the commission, following the assignment. And another thing, all of our assignments are not the same.
That's right.
You make it get up here and praise God in a praise day.
Thank you.
Bring the house down.
All right.
I get up here, I couldn't even move. I didn't know which direction to go. But if that's where God has called you to minister, praise my God, that's a praise.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Somebody, I tell you what, my first lady, I don't know another woman that can bring that word like that Sharon C. White.
Yes.
But I can't do it. That's not my God. But I have to do it. But I did have a commission to go.
All right.
To go.
Uh-huh.
We all don't have the same tongue. We all don't speak in the same tongue.
Right.
We all don't pray the same way.
Right.
But pray. He said pray.
Uh-huh.
Man should always pray and not faint.
That's right. That's right.
So we cannot allow the enemy to try to make us mimic somebody else.
Yes.
None of us the same.
Yep.
Nobody in here fingerprints are the same. So that let us know right there that God didn't mean for us all to do the same thing.
Yes.
To do it the same way.
Yep.
All we need to know that He said, go.
Go.
Go. Tell them.
Yes.
Teach them.
Yes.
We all don't teach the same way.
All right.
I am a Sunday school teacher, and in our church, it's two teachers to a class.
Uh-huh.
The other teacher that we teach totally different. Totally different. Sometimes on the day that she teach, I'm just sitting there. On the day I'm teaching, she's just, because we teach totally different.
Uh-huh.
So I can't get offended the way she teaches.
Amen.
I just, all I can do is say, God, you speak through me the way you want it done, the way that you say. We can't do all the same things.
Right.
And that's what happens sometimes among humans. They try to do it like somebody else.
All right.
Instead of allowing God to use you the way He chose you.
All right.
You know, can you imagine what this world naturally be if everybody you met looked just like me? My size, my height, my color, it'd be a dove, bland world.
All right.
But God made us all different.
Yes.
All
right.
He created us all different. All right. We have different tones, different voices.
Uh-huh.
Some people are quiet and soft. I'm loud.
All right.
Always have been. Loud. Me and Helen are two loudest people in unity. It's loud. But God used all of us differently.
Yes.
But the one thing we have in common, He says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Those things we have in common,
amen,
we have that same commission.
Amen.
Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I command you to do.
Amen.
He may command me to just go to the nursing home.
Right.
And just walk through and touch everybody in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
He may command you a whole different story. He may command you to go to the jail.
Right.
And just read the scriptures.
Yes.
Observe what He has commanded us to do. Me, you. I can't get jealous if you got a prison ministry. And I got something else to do.
Right.
My ministry just may be going into the home of the elders and just wash their dishes.
Amen.
If I go into that home and go in the name of Jesus,
amen,
praying while I'm doing it, asking God to move and touch in that home, that's my commission. So there's no certain list. He didn't make a list of things of commissions. But He said He gave us the commission. He gave us the order, and He did it with authority.
Yes,
all right.
We have that same authority.
Uh-huh.
Many times we miss out because we don't realize who we are.
Mm-hmm.
We don't realize the authority that we have.
All right.
And since the enemy knows that we don't realize the authority that we have, he takes advantage of that.
All right.
He abuses us. He walk into our families and tear our families up.
Yes.
Right.
He walk into the churches and tear the churches up.
Because
he don't realize, we don't realize, he realized that we don't realize the authority that has been given to us. But I walk in the authority daily that God has given me.
Right.
I command and I loose. I bind and I set free.
Because
God has given me the commission.
Yes.
Whatever I loose on earth, that He will loose in heaven. Whatever I bind on earth, that He will bind it in heaven.
Yes.
I refuse for the devil to torture and torment
me.
But I know who I am.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know that I am the righteousness of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I have to speak that thing openly in the atmosphere, saturate the atmosphere with who I am and what I am. I will be who God say I will be.
Yes.
I will do what God said I would do.
Yes.
I will have what God said I would. God said I can have eternal life.
Yes. Right. Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
But I have to do what He's asked me to do.
Yes.
All right.
You know, God didn't ask a whole lot of us.
Uh-huh.
He just asked a few things of us.
All right.
Now we forever crying out to Him, pleading and begging some things from all the time. But He didn't ask a whole lot of us. He just gave us a small commission.
All right.
A very small commission.
All right.
And that's all that He's requiring of us.
All right.
So today, to you, and to me, we have to heed to the call.
Amen.
The commandment has been given.
Yes.
The commission has been assigned.
All right.
If you don't know what your assignment is, ask God.
Ask God.
He will lead you.
Yes, He will.
He will order our footsteps His word.
Yes.
That's what the word of God says.
All right.
He will order our footsteps in His word. We don't know our purpose for being here.
Mm-hmm.
But Jeremiah 29:11 said, I know the plan.
Uh-huh.
He had a plan.
Uh-huh.
You know, we just sometimes just think that we just happen to be.
Uh-huh.
But God had a plan.
Yeah.
Had a purpose for each one of us.
Amen.
I was talking to my cousin once and not long ago, and she was saying, you know, I don't know what my purpose is. I don't have one. I said, yes, you do. I said, it's according to the word of God.
Amen.
We all have a purpose and a plan.
That's right.
She said, I don't know what it is. She said, let's just stand myself and being by myself. I said, that could be your purpose.
Uh-huh.
I said, you don't know how many people be blessed just by watching your life, mm-hmm. seeing that you are content being by yourself, that you can function and go on.
Amen.
If you're not in a crowd.
Amen.
I said, you know how people are tormented because they feel they have to fit in? I said, somebody just watching your life could take heed to that.
Uh-huh.
And say, if Lynette can be by herself and she's happy, she's
all
going
right.
on and prospering,
Amen.
And she's by herself and to herself, I don't have to be in a crowd.
Amen.
She said, I never thought about that.
Amen.
But the enemy always wants to make us think got to be the big thing. We got to be the great big person. We got to be on the front line. Because that's how people treat us. If you don't have a name or a big title, you know, you are nobody. That's in their eyesight.
Amen.
But that's not in the eyesight of God.
Amen.
God chose us because he loved us. When God sent his son Jesus die on Calvary Cross, he didn't do it for the aristocratic or the millionaires.
Right.
He did it for the world.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And in God's eyesight, there are no big eyes and little eyes. God loves us all enough.
Yes.
He sent his son to this earth.
Right.
Walk this earth in the form of a human man.
Yes.
Okay. Glory! And then go to that cross and die for a sin that he never committed.
All right.
What a mighty God we serve.
Right.
If God did all of that for us,
yeah.
why can't we do the few little things that he has commissioned us to do?
All right.
You don't have to leave home.
Uh-huh.
You don't have to leave the comfort of your home to fulfill that commission.
All right.
Because now we got all kind of apparatus that we can use.
Uh-huh.
If you can't leave out of your house, you can show up pick up your phone.
Uh-huh.
Even if you don't leave your house, even if you don't pick up your phone, you sure can walk through the house and
all
pick
right.
the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
We can pick the blood of a dying word.
Yes. Right. Yes. Yes.
We can pick the blood
yes.
over these gangs.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
I was walking down the street one day and I saw this graffiti in the street.
Thank you.
And somebody told me that the gangs had marked their turf.
My.
I said, that devil is a
lie.
He didn't have enough turf in the neighborhood I live in.
Right.
I went home.
Right.
And I anointed my shoes.
Right.
And with my bold self, I walked back there to my spot. That's what right. God in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
I burned this devil.
Yes.
Right. Ain't no gang coming now. God has given me the authority over this. He said, everywhere my feet tread, he gave us that spot.
Yeah.
I was not going to be living in fear.
Mm-hmm.
I can't say there were no gang members in the neighborhood. I don't know who they are.
All right.
But I know they've been bombarding no church in the neighborhood I live. We have to utilize what God has given us.
Yeah.
We have to be busy about that commission, that assignment he has given us.
Uh-huh.
We can take back our neighborhoods.
Thank you.
I hear all the little stuff about taking back our streets, taking back our neighborhoods. But they don't mean that.
Thank you,
they just want you to vote for them.
Thank you, Jesus.
They could care less about our neighborhoods.
Right.
They could care less about what's going on in our streets.
Right.
They could care less about what's going on in our schools.
Right.
All their kids go to USJ.
Yeah.
Trinity.
Yes.
What's the other school? Jackson Christian.
Yes.
So they don't care what's going on in the public schools. But it's up to us.
Yes.
They say you can't pray in the school. We sure can pray before they get to school.
Yes.
Whatever the commission is,
yes.
we'll help us.
Yes.
And as I go to my seat on this morning,
thank you, Jesus.
Think about it.
Thank you, Lord.
Remember, go.
All right.
Go.
Go.
To all the nations.
Yes.
Teaching. Baptizing them.
Yes.
You know, the gangs initiate their gang members.
Yes, they do.
Baptism is a sign of initiation.
Yes.
You're a part of Christ.
Yes.
Right.
You're dying to the sin.
Yes.
That's all baptism is. It's up to us.
Uh-huh.
What we're going to do.
Amen.
God has commanded. He's given the commission.
Amen.
It's our call.
Uh-huh.
We don't want to stand before God on the day of judgment.
No.
And hear God say, depart from me. You workers of iniquity.
Right.
I know you not.
Right.
But I want to do everything that I can while I have a chance.
Yes.
to build the kingdom of God.
Yes.
It ain't about titles. It ain't about positions.
No,
but it's all about building the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Saints of God, go.
Yes.